Shamai, welcome. In this tutorial, we're going to be looking at the M5StackSats. This uses the M5Stack, as we have in the last couple of tutorials, but it also uses something called the Faces Development Kit. Now, as a kit, it's great because it comes with a little keypad, so we can like turn this into a point-of-sale terminal. It also comes with a nice little docking station, which charges the unit as well. So you can plug the docking station in. It's got a magnetic back, or you can screw it onto the wall or something. And then, you know, when you're using not using your unit, you just pop it in there, and then it's charging, which is great. There's two versions of the project, as there was with the M5Stack 1.21. There's an open node version, and there's a Raspberry Blitz LND version. Or it'll work for any LND node, to be fair. So I'm going to fire these two devices on at the same time, and we should see those splash screens. That's the open node version, obviously. And then this is the LND or Raspberry Blitz version. They're just connecting to the Wi-Fi. Once they're connected to the Wi-Fi, there we go. I can input an amount. So say if I'll input like, I don't know, €0.05 or something. There we are. It's easy to convert these as well to like USD or British pound or whatever. And then once you've inputted the amount you want to pay, in fact, I won't pay that much, so I can cancel it. I'll pay 7 cents. I'll click on that one there. It says processing. It goes and fetches the invoice, and then it should display the invoice. Get my wallet, and then scan it. There we are. Click on pay, and then it should say paid, and the transaction is complete, and it goes on to the next customer. It's quite funny actually, because Rootsall posted a video of this in action in room 77 in Berlin, which is actually why I originally made this project. It's a Bitcoin bar in Berlin, and a load of Bcashers were complaining it was too slow, but as you saw there, it was as fast as any old point of sale terminal, which you would use say with your card, for example. I think it was more the fact that they'd had maybe a few too many beers. So that was quite funny. But yeah, maybe I'll play the clip now.
Clever.
Another try with a new Lightning POS system. The gentleman has to pay €16.
Which is about like this much, which is actually 173,614 Satoshis. I'm going to create the invoice here now. Maybe I'll try again, sorry.
Ta-da! Customer scanning our Lightning invoice. Clicking send, and we are complete.
Okay, try it.
Complete. Okay. Complete.
Okay, next. I'm in.
What was quite nice is I've got good feedback from Jorgen. I think this is a payment solution he'll actually use, which is great. And the Bitcoins we use would come into the bar. I myself can't wait to use the unit when I go to the Lightning conference in Berlin in a few months. So really looking forward to that. Anyway, without further ado, we're going to dive into the project. Now, there are two versions of this project. So we're not going to look at the LND Blitz version. The code is on the GitHub. Between this tutorial and the M5Stack 1.21 tutorial, you should be able to navigate your way through the file to be able to, you know, use it with your own LND or Raspberry Blitz. So we're going to focus on the open node version of this project. So if I click them on again, we can get the splash screen. We're going to focus on the open node version of this project because it's kind of the most accessible. Like, somebody could just order this unit and start accepting Bitcoin on Lightning using the open node service. So it's also a great unit for, you know, like the coffee shop down the road and they want to accept Bitcoin. You can give them one of these, set them with an open node account, and they can start accepting Bitcoin. If they start to earn a significant amount, they can use open node. They can output to a hardware wallet or something, or they could even convert to a bank account, I think, to cash. So quite useful for like introducing no coiners, and then, you know, this is an on ramp, and then over time then they might want to have that self-sovereignty and then run their own node, and that's cool too. So we're going to focus on the open node version. But the Blitz version is on the GitHub, so you know, if you want to do that, then please check it out. And if you look at the M5 Stack 1.21 Blitz version, it's basically the same code without the keypad, so you'll be able to work out how to make that work. As always, the project is on my GitHub, ArcBTC, and M5StackSats. There's two versions, the full node version and the custodial version. We're using the custodial open node version. A couple of links in the README. There's a link to the actual faces development kit, which you can order directly from M5Stack. It comes with another couple of faces, and you get a whole bunch of fun projects for like turning the thing into a Game Boy, and a whole bunch of other projects you can do with this module. So it's a module worth buying, and it's only $55. You can get it from AliExpress. I think it's there, AliExpress, for the same price, although you might have to do some searching for that. And you can also order it from Amazon, but I found it to be a lot more expensive on Amazon. There's a link also to downloading and installing the Arduino IDE, which you can do on Windows, Mac, and Linux, and a link for installing the ESP32 boards into the Arduino IDE. So this is ESP32 based. So in Arduino, you click on that link, it'll take you to this page here, click on instructions for board manager, you copy this URL, and you just drop it into preferences here. And then once you've done that, you can go to tools, board, and then at the top there, board manager, search for ESP32, and then you can install it directly from the boards manager in Arduino IDE. Once you've done that, you'll have all these extra boards to play with. And the one we're using is M5 Stack Core ESP32. I don't need that, so I'm gonna close that. You'll also need to install some libraries. So I recommend, if you're downloading the whole project, and once you've downloaded it, opening up the file, the zip, here we are, and then we're going to be using the open node version. But if you're using the Blitz version, just drag this into your sketchbook. So somewhere on your system where Arduino IDE is stored, there'll be a folder called sketchbook, and that's where all your little programs for the Arduino IDE are saved. Just drag and drop that in there, and then in fact, if I even got the folder open, I think I have. Yep, here we are, I've got it open here. So I'll just drag that. I wonder if I've already got one named that in there. No, I haven't. Oh, that's cool. So drag it in there, open him up. Okay. Right, now I'm going to talk you through the code quickly. So the first thing it does is it includes the splash image thing, which is this thing. Okay. And then there's a couple of libraries it goes through. So M5, well, the first library it's going to look for is LVGL. It's going to include that. So you want to install that from include library, manage libraries, search for LVGL, and it will, I think it's the only one which comes up, LVGL. There we are, install that. Should have left that open. The other one you want to install is M5Stack. It's M5Stack by M5Stack. And then Arduino JSON by Benoit, I think on the, I'll just double check that. Include library, manage libraries. Okay, Arduino JSON. Yeah, by Benoit. Okay, so install that one as well. That's just gonna, that's the library for parsing through the data, which comes back from OpenNode. They're the exact same three libraries you install as well if you're doing the Blitz version. Wi-Fi Client Secure, that library is included in the SP32 boards. Now I'm going to whiz through. Okay, so here's where you add your Wi-Fi credentials so the thing can connect to the internet. Here's where you add your API key. So if you haven't already, go to OpenNode, make an account, generate an invoice API key. It's a very straightforward procedure. I think you need to allow 2FA in order to generate API keys. But then once you've done that, you can generate an invoice API key. A whole bunch of variables here. The only real important one is where you set your native currency. And that's all you need to change is this thing here. So if you want USD, just change that to USD. If you want GBP, change it to GBP. If you want euros, change it to euros. Right, okay, some more variables. So, and you can see here, actually, the first variable after that, it just takes the euro bit, which is a substring thing here, and stores it in this little variable called on subcurrency. So we can use that to specify our currency when we communicate with OpenNode. Right, so there's a whole bunch of functions. Now, let me talk you through some of the functions. There's the page input function. This is just the bit which you can see, which says like euro and sats. This is before you've actually entered an amount. When you enter an amount, it's actually using a separate kind of function. So this just sort of stays on the page. Here's the page processing bit where it says processing once you press the little the continue button. There's a keypad function, so this does some magic to register the characters which you're pressing on the keypad. And it also disallows you to press, because it's a calculator, the keypad we're using, there's like times, plus, and equals, and we don't want the ability to be able to press those, so it kind of like cancels those buttons, so you can only press the number buttons on the keypad. And then here's the little function for displaying the QR code. Oh, I pasted that. All Arduino programs have two functions, they have to have two functions, a setup function and a main function. So in the setup functions, the first thing the Arduino does, the ESP32 does, which is, so it turns on the M5 stack, it draws the image, and then it connects to the Wi-Fi, and then it uses this function called onRates to go and get the rates from OpenNode. So we'll have a little look at that. So down the bottom, we've got some the OpenNode requests, the get and post request. The first one is just a simple get request, and it's requesting the rates. And it uses that substring, the EU or USD or GBP to get the right currency conversion rate. It's pretty cool. Once it's done that, we move on to the main loop, and this is where it gets a little bit complicated. It's basically like a couple of nested while loops. So the first while loop is on the keypad buttons which are pressed, basically. So if we go down here, okay, so when you input into the keypad, obviously that then gets converted on the fly. And then if you look here, set cursor and set cursor here, so it prints to the little, to the LCD, to the screen, the fiat, which is the, you know, what is in euros, and then the Satoshi version of that converted. And then it just kind of prints it over this page input bit here. So that's that while loop. And then there's kind of another while loop in what, so it checks to see what buttons are being pressed, and then it does that. If the C button is pressed, that's like the continue button, then it shows the page processing. So processing on the page, then it requests an invoice from OpenNode using another a post request down here. Once it's requested the invoice, it displays it as a QR code, and then it checks to see if it's being paid. If it's unpaid, it just kind of loops around, and the QR will eventually time out and go refresh to the page input page. However, if it is paid, then it will say complete on the screen, wait a couple of seconds, and then the whole thing will start again, and it will show the page input page. There is the ability as well to cancel, so when the QR code is there, you can press the A button. So that's the first button on the actual M5 stack bit just under the LCD, and that will cancel it. And also you can press the same button when you're actually inputting the amount. If you input the wrong number, you can press the A button, it'll cancel it. And that is pretty much it. That's pretty much how it works. Obviously, I've just skimmed through the code here because there is quite a lot to get through. But in saying that, you know, we've made a point of sale terminal, so on Lightning Network. So there's, you know, there's not as much code as you probably would think there would be. But it's still a bit of a tangle to kind of get through. I'll input my credentials now, and then I'll flash the device and see if it works. There we go. It's uploaded. We've got our splash screen. There we are. We can enter our amount. Let's enter 50 cents. Click on the little button here. The buttons need jazzing up, so maybe a little red cross or on the A button for cancelling, and then maybe like a little green tick or a little lightning bolt maybe for the C button would be quite nice. Okay, it's got the QR code already. That's really fast. I'm gonna scan it. And scanning. There we are. Click pay. I'm paid. You should get a complete. Nice. And then you're ready for the next customer. Obviously, you know, you can take this. This doesn't need to be plugged in. The actual, you can just plug the docking station in and then put that somewhere behind the bar or in the cafe or whatever. And that just sits in there. And it's just charging now as you speak. And it's just there. People can just grab it when they need to use it. Boom, boom, boom. Get someone to pay. Boom, boom, boom. So really simple, really easy, really straightforward. Thanks for watching the tutorial. Good luck to those who are using the Blitz version. If you do get stuck, you know, you can always hit me on Twitter or in the comments of the video or whatever, and I'll get back to you. Apart from that, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Cheers.